I remember, Michael, when I first got here, he was a member of our church. He left. He came back as a minister. He has graced us with his intelligence, his creativity, and his elegance. And everything that's elegant around here probably came from Michael. So that was a great thing. But now he's seasons change. Things come and go, and now he'll be going back to New York.
New York?
The Big Apple?
The city that never sleeps.
Start spreading. I want to be a part of it. New York, New York. These vagabond shoes are longing to stray right through the very heart of it. New York. City that doesn't sleep, and find I'm king of the hill, top of the heap. It's up to you.
How about that? Oh. And I was just trying to avert my eyes so I didn't lose it looking at Dan Adair. Then this happens. My God. Oh. Never in my life. Never in my life. I wish I could take what's in my heart and just cover you all with it right now. Okay, and I had a whole service to get composed. So I want to, first of all, wow. Did you get that, Brad? Did you get that on the, did people take pictures? Okay, good. First of all, I want to really thank you for the many, many wonderful different ways. Many and most of you have sent me an email or a card or spoken to me, and in such beautiful, touching ways. It's just meant the world to me. And thank God I took Kathy Ann's Receiving My Good workshop. What? It helps at moments like this. And. And speaking of Kathy Ann, I just need to acknowledge and the many years of relationship with her where she has coached and loved me and supported me and encouraged me and asked me to be things I never thought possible. And she knows I love her, and thank you so much. And And I just want to take an opportunity to introduce you to someone who's taken me away from all of this, because he's created a new opportunity and invited me to join with him in doing the good work that he is so wonderfully, amazingly doing in the world. Brad Lamb, flew into New York to be here today. Now I'm going to do something weird with you, okay? First of all, I'm deputizing you all as spiritual rabble-rousers. Okay, good. And I've been a part of this church for 27 years, and so I think I have a perspective. And I want to say to you, you in particular, do you know who you are? Do you know the kind of power and love and kindness and generosity and the kind of actions that you take in this world are so special and different and unique than any other part of our congregation has ever been at any time? And so I'm going to ask you, as who you are, to step forward as you are, to truly, truly step into your power and to your knowledge and into your heart and make this church just smoke, because it's ready. So when I do weddings, I always ask people who come to the wedding, I say, if you want to support, do you commit to supporting and loving and honoring and helping this couple as they move forward into life? And I say, if you do, say, I do. And they say, I do. So I'm going to ask you right now, do you commit to being the full power of who you are and knowing that and stepping out into the world and making a difference that this church can and always does make? If you can, will you say, I do for me? I think you mean it. And I'm taking your word for it. Thank you so much for loving me. I love you so much.